guys, welcome back to Warroad Mechanics. Thank you guys for watching and subscribing to the channel. In today's video, guys, we'll be working here on a Dodge Journey. This same vehicle in Europe and the rest of the world is known as Fiat Fremont. So, if you have any of the two vehicles, guys, the video will be helpful. Now, if your cruise control buttons, switches here, controls do not work, okay, we'll show you guys how to remove and how to replace them. Also, those right here, and you have steering wheel controls on the back side. Okay, right here. All those guys, we'll show you today how to do it. We have to remove the airbag and all that stuff to do it the correct way. Otherwise, you can cause some serious damage and you can hurt yourself and kill yourself without airbags. So, let's go ahead and start on it, guys. All the tools and parts that we use, you can find them listed in the description of the video below. And we'll have more than 200 videos on this car. So, please subscribe. We try to save you as much money as we can. First, guys, we'll need to disconnect our car battery. As you know, the car battery is behind the bumper in front of the wheel, really inconvenient place. So there is another way to disconnect it, we need to show you, but you need to make sure that you isolate the cables really good and they don't touch in the meantime while you're working on your car. Now, you have to disconnect your car battery at least 1 hour before you work on the airbag system. And again, if you're not qualified to do work on airbag systems, do not do it, because those things, they can kill you. Okay, so consider that entertaining video and not so much on a how-to video. So we're going to go ahead, okay, and disconnect the negative cable first. Okay, that's the one that we need to disconnect. So from right here, okay, you can see we can go ahead and disconnect. Okay, that nut, this is the negative terminal that comes directly from the battery of your vehicle. Okay, careful not to drop that nut. If you guys need help with anything specific, drop a comment below. We'll try our best to make a video for your problem. So, this one is disconnected now. Okay, the nut is done. What we're going to do now, guys, okay, this is the battery negative cable, you can see. So practically now, okay, the car, okay, will not have power. So we're going to go ahead and insulate the cable here, the wire. This is your positive one. Okay, and I'll show you which one is the one that comes from the battery once we remove it. It's always important how you disconnect those things. You need to disconnect, okay, the negative first and then the positive. Connecting, it's the opposite way. Okay, you connect the positive first and disconnect the negative. So, pull that cable out. This is the one, okay, this right here. Okay, this is the guy coming from the battery. Okay, that cable right here. So we need to insulate this one. That's the one that's feeding the fuse box as well there. Okay, perfect. So we wait 1 hour and we can continue, okay, with the next step. Okay, next, what we need to do, okay, we need to get a 10 millimeter socket, and on the back side, guys, of the steering wheel, okay, let me show you. Let me pull the steering wheel out, okay, so you can see a little bit better. Okay, right here there is a cap. Okay, this cap will need to be removed. So, with a small screwdriver now, okay, I'm going to pry that thing open like that. And with a 10 millimeter socket, okay, we're going to get that bolt loose. Now, let me see. Okay, if that bolt will come off. Okay, it's still holding a little bit. So this is the bolt, guys, right here. What I'll do next, okay, you have to be careful. Do not shake the airbag too much because it's loose on one side. Okay, I'm going to turn the steering wheel to this side so I can show you. Okay, we'll be doing the same thing to this one here. Okay, perfect. Now let me get this one loose. Now you have to hold your airbag with one hand because it will start dropping. Second bolt came out. I'm holding the airbag now, so let me just turn the steering wheel. Okay, so you can see. Okay, what I'm doing now. Gently grab it, don't have anything metal. Be very careful with your wires as well. And now, okay, we'll need to go ahead, guys. Okay, and disconnect all the wires now. So with a plastic panel removal too, okay, this clip will need to come out. Okay, just like that. Now, we have another wire here. Okay, guys, this is for, I think this is a ground wire. So I need to get the small screwdriver for this one now to disconnect it. You have to be extremely, extremely careful. Okay, like that. Now this is your airbag right here. And let me show you how we're going to disconnect the cables. You can see they have two teeth here, okay? Oh, let me see where I dropped the screwdriver. Okay, right here. Never ever touch with metal things like I do. I'm just using that to show you. So grab it with your nails, okay? And never ever twist the wires left or right. Just go straight up. Okay, like this one. Now the same thing to the black one. Perfect. And the airbag came out of the way now. Now, why we had to remove the airbag, you can see because the steering wheel buttons, okay, right here, they go under the airbag. Practically, if you bend them a little bit, you can remove them, but I wouldn't recommend it because if you do something stupid, you can damage your airbag, so be careful. Now, stay with us, guys, and we'll show you how to remove them. Okay, next, guys, extend your steering wheel again. Okay, let me see which way to go. That will give me a little bit more room, like that. We'll be using a Torx 15, but I believe this one could be 20 or 17, but 15 in our case works. Different years use different size. Okay, let me see to get a little bit more room. Yep, like that one. And just start taking that one loose, that bolt. Okay, it's a screw, you can see. So probably that's close to 20. We'll get our 20 and check. I think it's a Torx 20. You can find all the tools, guys, that we use in the description of the video below. So I'll do the same thing to this side now. Okay, let me come on this side. And we're going to remove this one now for the other control. Okay, we are almost out now. Okay, we have a video, guys, how to wash your steering wheel because you can see this thing is nasty. Now, I'm going to straighten it so I can show you what we'll be doing next. Now, you grab one of the controls. Okay, gently pull it out. Right here, guys, you can see that tooth. Okay, that little tooth. You need to press in. Okay, and wiggle the wire out, and you can see this is your cruise control switch right here. This one on this side, this is for the menu. Okay, we have less things to do, less wires. Okay, you can see we pulled that one out. Both of them are out just like that. Now if you need to replace these buttons, okay, what do you have to do now, guys? You have to remove the steering wheel. Okay, we have to remove that bolt, pull the steering wheel, careful with the wires. We will have a video how to remove the steering wheel. And that cover later, it will push out and you'll be able to replace your, okay, you can see your steering wheel radio control. So Pretty simple. Check out the video on our channel how to remove the steering wheel if you need help with that, but that's how you guys do it. So you can see those are the controls. We're going to get new ones, put them together, and we'll continue with the installation in just a second. So we get the new buttons now. You have to be careful when you detail your car not to get them wet or anything like that, because that's the number one reason, or if you spill something on them. Why they go bad. So we install this one now. All we have to do, get the screw in. I got a Torx 20 now, start looking big, Torx 20. And just start getting this one tight. It's a little bit of uncomfortable angle here, so let me see if I can go up a little bit, maybe go down with the steering wheel so I have a little bit more room. This one is almost there. The left one, for some reason, one of them will be always tighter than the other one. I don't know why. Haven't figured out why. This one is ready to go. Now we do the same thing to this one, guys. Just push that thing in, and we need to go ahead and install the same screw on the other side. And after that you have to install your airbag. If you need help with that, we'll have a video on the channel, check it out. But pretty much, guys, this is the whole procedure. So thank you guys for watching. Please subscribe to the channel and see you guys next time.